Hello everyone, my name's Helen. Welcome to my channel. Today I'm gonna try out two different things against each other that I have not seen tested one against the other so far, so this should be kind of interesting. On one side of my hairline here, and this is why I've got this headband on, I'm trying to pull back all the little baby hairs and fly away so that they stay flat so we can just get a good look at my missing hair from my temples. On one side, we're gonna try just plain old eyeshadow because I know people love this trick. It's inexpensive. This is like a $3 Rimmel pure black eyeshadow I've had kicking around for ages now. So we're gonna just try applying this on one side and we're gonna try applying hair fibers. This is actually my Toppik hair fibers on this side. And we're gonna coat them with some hairspray after and we're just gonna give them a wear test and then we will circle back and see how one performs against the other, whether it looks more natural. I'll take you guys outside and we'll maybe have like a little bit of a light test if that makes sense. So we're gonna see, we're gonna stack up the $3 solution versus the 30-ish, 25-ish dollar solution, and we're gonna see which looks better and which holds up better and all that kind of stuff. So if you're interested in all that, all you gotta do is stay tuned. The upside, of course, to using hair fibers is that it is just so quick. So I've got a tissue, and if you are gonna use these, I would strongly suggest you sort of place this over your face. Otherwise, the little overspray bits can go onto your face, which I'm guessing is probably not the look you're going for. But, you know, you just tap these on and in just a second, they cover up your spots. It's crazy. Let me get a bit closer here. See, I got overspray on my hand. We don't want that. Okay, done. Pat, 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 right? Pat this down and I think you'll see that it is more filled in than it was. Right? So you don't really see any visible scalp there. I mean, contrast that to like the middle there, right? You can see that it's much darker. So that only takes a few seconds. Once it's on, I like to hit it with a bit of hairspray and that just sort of locks it in for the day. So I'm gonna do that. This is just an unscented hairspray. It's Elnett, L'Oreal Elnett. I hear that you can't get this in the US. This is pretty readily available here in Canada and I think also in the UK, but people have told me that they don't see it. But anyhow, unscented hairspray, pop that in and that should lock it. That should do a pretty good job of locking it. Now let's get into the eyeshadow of it all. This is not my preferred method to use eyeshadow just because I find it takes a long time. The fibers are quick, but this is not bad either. This doesn't take a whole lot of time. So here we are, I'm just building up this area here. I will say, I mean, you can use a little spongy thing. In fact, that doesn't look bad at all if you don't have a brush, right? A brow brush is what I use if I want to. This is another good brush, like if you're just like on a budget and you want just like a budget option, this e.l.f. Eyebrow Duo, you can also use for your eyebrows as well, and it's got the spoolie on the other end, and I think I paid a couple dollars for this. This is not expensive, but you know, it will take longer because the brush is quite tiny. So yeah, I mean, you can use your finger as well, right? So I'm just dipping in there. So when you are picking out an eyeshadow for your hair, just be sure that you're getting something that's matte. This is very matte and this is jet black and I think it's actually not the best color for my hair. A really, really dark brown would have been a bit better because it's almost blue black. So it's not perfect, but you know, again, it's covering up my scalp and I've even tried smudging it in with my finger and that works well. So all those methods can work totally well. So when you are at the drugstore and you're trying to pick out one of these singles, if that's what you want to do, or maybe you want to get like two of them if you have like a hair color that's got more depth in it. Mine is pretty just all over quite dark, but like say you're an auburn or a blonde with some darker pieces or low lights or highlights or whatever the case may be, you might need to choose two, maybe even three single shadows. Check it in the light. What you want to do is just rotate it and make sure there are no shimmery bits in it, right? Because if you see a lot of shimmery bits, guess what? When you put it in your hair, it's gonna look a little shimmery too. So you wanna make sure you get the mattest eyeshadow that you can and that's gonna look the most natural and it's gonna look like a shadow. Again, this is a bit dark, but you know, is what it is. I'm gonna, for any parts that are not looking so smooth, just, that's what the spoolie comes in handy for. So that's what spoolies are great at doing, blending it out. You can use your fingers to blend it out as well. I think that looks pretty good as well, right? Definitely less visible scalp. I might go and put in a little bit more. Yeah. So it is a bit harder to blend out the lines if you do get some lines. Those take a bit more time. So, you know, you are looking at a bit more of a time commitment, even though this costs a lot less. So I think that that's not bad. I think that a lot less of my scalp is visible, certainly if you compare it to this area where I didn't put anything. It's a lot less visible, right? Okay, so let's hit that with some hairspray now to lock it. And the reason I use hairspray is just to kind of lock it down. Kind of like how people use setting spray on their makeup. Well, we're gonna let that dry and we're gonna even go outside and do all that kind of stuff. And let's give it a try out in the real world. Here I am outside in about the strongest sun imaginable. It is spring as I'm filming this, and please don't look at my bad skin. It's not looking good, but let's look here instead. So this is the side that has the fibers. This is the side that has the eyeshadow. And what I'm thinking, and you guys can let me know if you agree or not, is that the side with the fibers looks more just dark. Not very differentiated, just dark. And this side has more strokes in it, probably because you can actually put strokes in when you use the eyeshadow. And it looks more natural, I think. But the color is not as good on this side, which is not entirely surprising, right? It's kind of hard to match your hair color with eyeshadow, because eyeshadow is not really meant to match hair color, whereas these fibers are specifically formulated to match different hair shades. Overall, I'd say they're pretty close, but you know what we'll do? We'll do an overnight test for all you walk of shame girls and guys out there. In case you don't have anything with you, we'll see how it looks the next day. It is the next morning. Go ahead and give this video a like and consider subscribing if you don't mind, because you know what? Every subscription and every like helps that little bit, helps us support the work that I do here at no cost to you. I don't take any sponsorships for hair loss related products. So yeah, go ahead and do that. That would really help me out. So I know that the footage, I had a look at it, and I know that it wasn't super dark. As soon as you get in like bright sunlight, you just don't see these products that well, which I guess is a good thing. They just tend to look like shadows, which means I guess I blended it quite well. So that's good. So what I did though was I darkened them up yesterday afternoon so that I could really do a full wear test until the next day. So I just went back in there and darkened up those areas, and I haven't touched them since. So slept overnight in them, and we're gonna have a look. We're gonna have a look at my bed and my pillow. So some interesting things happened. I'm gonna share them with you in a second. I would be remiss not to mention some of the other products that you can use. If you don't wanna use eyeshadow, of course there are now eyebrow powders, which are much more readily available than they were like 6-7 years ago. These are, you can find them at any price point, and of course that will help you get something that will be more suited to your actual hair color, because eyeshadow is not meant for your hairline, but brow powder is meant for your eyebrows, which is hair that is often close to your natural hair color, or not. But anyhow, there tends to be a spectrum of more naturalistic looking hair colors when you get into the eyebrow powder. And eyebrow powder is actually pretty much just eyeshadow formulated a little bit differently to use on your eyebrows, even though the name is a little bit different. Like, it's not called eyebrow shadow, but it could be, you know what I'm trying to say? Okay, the pillow situation. This was interesting. My actual pillow itself did not seem to accumulate neither any of the eyeshadow really, nor other, or the fibers, you know, and that's what the fibers say. When you look at them, they say it doesn't like rub off on your pillow or anything like that. But here's something interesting. So this in fact did not go anywhere, the eyeshadow. It hasn't budged. And if I go like this, you can see that there is still some here. And if I go like this, you can see that that comes off of my fingers too. So, you know, they do rub off if you put some friction onto them. But guess what? I looked under the pillow onto the actual mattress, and there were some black hair fibers. So they, the static, or however that they work, the mechanism through which they work and the mechanism through which they can fall back out of your hair, did fall out, but it didn't cling to my pillow. It clinged to my actual sheet underneath. So that's something interesting to know for those of you maybe who are like on white linens, or you're visiting someone and you're wondering if your powder or whatever is gonna rub off. I didn't have too much rub with the eyeshadow. Not saying it couldn't happen, but I did have some fallout with the actual fibers. But I'm pretty sure you can just dust those off with your hand. It's not really that big of a deal, but just something to be aware of, right? Because sometimes we're staying over at somebody's house, that walk of shame that I was talking about. There's a ton of reasons why you just might not want your hair fibers or your eyeshadow to fall out somewhere. So just be warned, it can happen, and that's what happened in this case. Okay, so just down to, do I have a preference between the two? You know, they both serve a really good purpose, and I think that they both look really good. I'm looking at myself in the mirror here the next day. I'll come up closer for you guys. They both look fine. They look totally similar in a way, so I don't think really from a visibility or a sort of aesthetic perspective, one is a lot better than the other, but I will say, I do think eyeshadow is suitable for smallerish areas, and I think that the fibers are better for like a larger area. I don't know about you, but also like in the back here is quite hard to see, so I think it's just easier just to shake this in and cover up any kind of thinning or bald spots you can't see that well than trying to fill it in with an eyeshadow. But of course, in a pinch, eyeshadow works great, and it seems to have the added advantage, at least in my case, of not having rubbed off on the pillowcase or on the linens on my bed. So there you have it. They're both good. You know, this is a $30 thing versus like a $30 thing. So if it's definitely a budgetary thing, hey, you can't go wrong with the eyeshadow. I think it looks really good. And if you're just looking for quickness, ease, or you have a lot of area to cover, or you just can't reach it that well, definitely I think the hair fibers are the way to go. So I think that they're both good. They're just probably appropriate for different reasons. All right, everybody, I'm gonna wrap it up there. I hope this was helpful to you. And thank you so much, as always, for joining me and spending your valuable time with me. And we will see you soon.